I'm going to define a software systems architecture as the set of principal design decisions about the system, where principal here implies a degree of importance that grants a design decision architectural status. And the point here, as we discussed with Nino early on, is that when building a system, we make tons of design decisions, and most of them do not affect the architecture of the system. For example, the fact of choosing a for loop instead of a while loop in the code, or the fact of deciding that we're going to use data structure A instead of data structure B. Some decisions, however, do affect the architecture of the system. And in some cases, the distinction between these two kinds of design decisions is clear. In some other cases, it is much fuzzier, and it depends on the context. The bottom line here is that if you believe that something is an important design decision, that becomes an architectural decision. That is, a decision that impacts a system's architecture. In this spirit, we can see a software architecture as the blueprint for a software system that we can use to construct and evolve the system. And the key point about software architecture is that this blueprint encompasses every facet of the system under development. It encompasses its structure, of course, but not only. It also involves the behavior of the system, the interactions within the system, and the non-functional properties of the system. And we will see how this happens in the rest of the lesson. Another important point about software architecture is that there is a temporal aspect to it. And the point here is that you don't build a software architecture in a single shot, but you do it iteratively, over time. So basically, you go from having no architecture to your final architecture. So at any point in time, there is a software architecture, but it will change over time. And this happens because design decisions are made, unmade, and changed over a system's lifetime.